Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note to YouTube channel, and yes, it's been a while, and yes, I'm alive. I've just been incredibly busy with the Android programming project, but I finally have time to do some videos again. So I thought I'd start out with one that you might find useful, and this is a problem that you'll encounter eventually. So one day you will notice this problem. When you're flipping through, it's going to... any day now. I'll go to my apps, maybe we'll see it there. So I pressed my apps button and you could see that it did take some time to get there. So why it did that? And you could see it's slow to respond, right? Eventually it will swipe. Any day now. There we go. So you will keep on swiping and you see there was a little lag there. Okay. There we go. Another lag there. So this is a problem that everyone will encounter eventually, but luckily, as long as you recognize the problem, the fix is very simple. You have run out of space on your internal storage. Maybe you have like 100 megs left, or maybe even a couple of hundred megs left, but that's not adequate. It needs a little extra space to do exactly what I'm not sure, but I am 100% sure that this is what's causing the problem. And my recommendation is to make sure you have about 2 gigabytes of free space on your internal storage. So there are a couple of ways you could do that. You could make sure you don't have anything in your DCIM camera folder, right? When you take pictures, sometimes it still ends up in your internal storage for some reason. Just go through that folder, just clean it out, put in your SD card, and maybe stuff that you have downloaded also. It always downloads to your internal storage. And that's all you need to do. Once you put minimum 2 gigs of space on your internal storage again, everything should be smooth. Anyway, I'll be putting more videos together for the Galaxy Note 2, and I'll be getting a Galaxy Note 3 as well, and integrate that into this channel. For people who are keeping the Note 2 for another year, I'll try to find solutions for you guys if the Note 3 happens to come with features that can be incorporated into the Note 2 by an app or workaround. So it's good to be back. I hope you are all doing well. I look forward to bringing you more content. Make sure you check out my other videos on the Note 2 in my channel and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And once again, thank you for watching.